Hello, hello everyone. So please give me a moment while I share this out. If you're watching the replay, you will probably want to skip and fast forward through the first like five-ish minutes. And if you're watching this, please say hello. And hopefully comments are showing up. If not, I'm also on here on my computer, so that should help. Hello, hello, everyone. If you're watching this, please don't be afraid to say hello. And give me a second here while I finish sharing this out. Hello, Amanda Panda. And thank you, I like it too. I've been really good. How have you been? Hold on, everyone. I'm still sharing this out. All right, that doesn't sound that fantastic. Pushing through. Yeah, pretty much. Aren't we all? Alrighty, I think I'm just about done here. Thank you. Alrighty, guys. Let's do this. Right after I hit skip ad. So, welcome everyone, and happy 4/4 portal. So, I wanted to talk a little bit today before we get into the meditation about the significance of this particular number and therefore the significance of this particular portal. So 444 has, since the beginning of my spiritual awakening, been my number. For me, and for a lot of other people I know as well, it means holding faith that whatever decision or choices I make financially will be fully supported by my guides and my angels and the divine God source universe creator. So throughout my spiritual journey, I have made decisions based on knowing that I was 100% completely supported at all times, which some people living more in the 3D would have deemed unwise, but for me it's always worked out because I've always known that I was 100% supported. And that anything that I choose to do, or I should reword this, any choice that I make regarding my future development on my spiritual journey, like for instance, paying for a course or learning a new modality or anything like this, any way in which I put my money towards this has always been fully supported, and it's always ended up paying me back in the long run, because I always get the money back somehow, some way, and I always manage to get all of my bills paid and everything like that, even when I'm spending my money in some ways unwisely. So that's what it means for me personally, but the 4/4 also means a very important thing. And I also want to point out here, I just kind of reminded myself mentally that this is a number 4 year, because 2020 in numerology breaks down to 4. So we have a number 4 year, and we have a number 4/4 portal. So all this put together is 444. But now let me get back to where I was at just a second ago. The number 4/4, signifying this 4/4 portal, is about creating peace in our lives based on all of the spiritual healing and all of the shifting and all of the changing and developing that we have done up to this point on our spiritual journey, and our life beginning to reflect that. So, in other words, this is a significant point for us. We start out with the number one being all about us and our inner life, our inner work, our spiritual journey. And then we get the number two, which is us and our significant other, or whoever is in the role of the divine masculine in our life. And then we get the number three, which is ourselves and those closest to us, but not involved with us intimately. Friends, family members, and coworkers. And then we have the number four, and that is global. This is beyond intimate partners. This is beyond friends and family and coworkers. This is everybody. And this is how we relate within society, how we feel we relate within society. And this is the work of breaking down those barriers and those boxes that we have put ourselves in and that we have allowed other people to put us in within society. This is shifting and changing how we feel and how others feel we fit in within society. And this is why, with everything that's going on right now, with this global awakening that a lot of people are going to be having, and with those of us who are already awakened, the deepening of their spiritual journey and learning how to be more of service and what to do with all of this stuff that they've discovered that they have the ability to do, all of their gifts and psychic abilities and everything. Those particular people are going to be delving deeper into, or perhaps just delving into to begin with, how they can assist the world, how they can be of service. And perhaps those of us who have already been doing this will be learning new modalities and learning different ways to be of service, and just sort of deepening all of that type of stuff. So, with everything that's going on in the world right now, and with this 4-4 portal, I wanted to jump on here and do a special healing meditation for releasing anything that might be keeping us from having this step forward through this portal. And I do want to point out that if there is something within you that just isn't quite ready to shift yet at this time, that this 4-4 portal is bringing up, that's perfectly fine. It will end up shifting at a later date, whenever it is that you are ready, or whenever that aspect or part of you is ready for it. So you'll end up catching up with all of us sooner or later, whenever it is that you're ready for it. Hi, Rebecca. Long time no see. So the question that seems to be coming to mind here is, how can we be of service? And how can we improve upon, shift, and transform how we feel we fit into society? And how can we shift and transform the boxes that we have allowed other people to put us in? So I'll give you guys those questions to think about. throughout this meditation. And now the reason that the description of this live video has Ishtar and Isis is because these are the two cards that literally jumped out of my deck when I was trying to pull a card for whichever goddess wants to participate with this meditation with us. And the two cards that I got, obviously, are Ishtar and Isis. So let me read a little bit about Ishtar. And I feel like this is a really significant card, especially at this time of year for us in the Northern Hemisphere. Ishtar is a multi-layered Babylonian creator goddess, the source of all life and the physical embodiment of the power of nature. She is the giver of plenty, a lawgiver, a judge, the goddess of time, as well as the goddess of both love and war. Her name means giver of light and derives from her role as queen of heaven. She is the planet Venus as both morning and evening star, and her girdle is the zodiac belt. Ishtar descends to the underworld and restores the vegetation god Tammuz to life, and thus restores fertility to the earth. As she descends, she removes a veil at each gate. While she is underground, all life on Earth is depressed and nothing comes to life. Ishtar is a multifaceted, powerful symbol of a forthright mode of being that is unafraid to venture into the depths of the underworld. She represents the creative feminine, active and strong. So the reason why I feel that this is a significant card for us right now is because Ishtar has a feast day. Of course, pretty much all goddesses have feast days, but her feast day used to be the feast day that we now call Easter. She is the spring goddess. She is the one who causes all life and all vegetation to spring back to life. And with us being in the early onset of spring here in the Northern Hemisphere, we are just now, just barely having things coming to life. And I feel like she wants to be our guide into those aspects of us which we may be scared of, or which we may be reluctant to delve into, those aspects of us which we are now having come up for us with this 4-4 portal to have us heal and shift and change these particular aspects. So she wants to help us be unafraid to venture into this healing and this shifting that we are now being called upon to do regarding how we fit into society and how we can be of service to the world. And the next card I got, I was only going to pull one, but they both literally jumped out at the same time, is Isis. Isis is the universal goddess representing total femininity. She can overcome death itself, yet she is not above grief. One of her tears wept while her husband Osiris was dying, caused the Nile River to flood. She underscores the depth of emotion that even a goddess must feel. And I'm picking up that she wanted to be a part of this particular meditation because there are a lot of us, I'm getting the message, who are repressing their emotions, who are not wanting to feel however it is that they're feeling. We might be judging ourselves and telling ourselves that we shouldn't feel that way for whatever reason. Or perhaps it's just a really painful emotion or just a really overall uncomfortable emotion. Or it could also be something that we're just scared to face, something that we're just not quite sure how to process. But whichever way it is, we are in good hands here with Isis and also with Ishtar. So after all this talking, let me grab a bit to drink here. I got very thirsty. And now let's get to the healing and cord cutting meditation. For this meditation, I am going to call in Archangel Michael for protection. I am going to call in Lord Ganesh, who is the elephant-headed Hindu god, or not exactly god, but ascended master. He has a knack for, or I would say he's the guru of breaking through obstacles that seem impassable and unsurmountable. And I sense that some of us are feeling very stuck with this particular aspect of us, with how we fit into society, with how we can be of service to the world, breaking down those boxes and those barriers can sometimes make us feel quite stuck. And I'm also going to call in Isis, of course, and Ishtar. And I'm also going to call in I can feel somebody trying to come in, but I'm not quite sure who it is, so I haven't named them yet. Goddess Sophia and Mary Magdalene. and Archangel Raphael, the Archangel of Deep Healing, is also here. Archangel Gabriel. Well, I have not worked a whole hell of a lot, but he is the Archangel of the Compassionate Heart, helping us to forgive both ourselves and others. Goddess Sophia is the self-esteem guru, as is Mary Magdalene, as well as the physical embodiment of the healed and ascended divine feminine. And now, whenever you're ready, you can close your eyes and picture a beam of super bright white light shining down upon the top of your head. And this beam of light will go all the way through your body, filling you up with love and light and compassion and joy. And now focus your attention approximately 2 feet above your head, where your personal sun or soul star chakra, or no, not soul star chakra, your galactic sun chakra is located. And now picture golden light shining down upon you, along with the angelic white light. And let this golden light soak up into your being, absorb it like you would a really good moisturizer. Let it soak into your soul. And now focus your attention about 1 foot above your head, where your actual soul star chakra is. And I'm sensing that this is a really important chakra, because this is the one that relates to you and other aspects of you from other timelines, whether it be alternate realities in this lifetime or past life aspects of you which are coming through now. Or perhaps even future life aspects. So for this particular chakra, we're going to do some cord cutting. Lord Ganesh and Archangel Michael, please cut any and all energetic attachments or cords to people, places, things, emotions, or feelings or thoughts interfering with our ability to connect with all aspects of us from all timelines. Archangel Michael, please create a barrier of protection and please be our guide into these different aspects of us to provide support and protection at all times. Ishtar, also be our guide into these different aspects within ourselves from all possible timelines or alternate realities. Allow us to see, sense, witness, and recognize that these are aspects of us from alternate realities or other timelines. Please allow us to differentiate between these aspects of us and ourselves. I'm sensing that a lot of us have been having basically like this possession type thing where especially a past life aspect of us ends up making us feel a certain way, making us react in a certain way, and making us feel quite crazy because we don't always know or realize exactly why it is that we're feeling this way or behaving this way. So hopefully, in the days, weeks, and months ahead, this will become more and more clear as to why we're feeling this way, why we're being called, or I should say being motivated to behave in this way, what our trigger point is, and where it came from. And I'm just pausing here for a moment to allow this healing that Archangel Raphael and actually Archangel Gabrielle are doing for our soul star chakras. And also for all of these different aspects within us. and whatever trigger point they might be having, whatever it is that they're being triggered by, and whatever it is within them that's causing them to be triggered. Healing the bleed through effect of this basically possession of us by them, making us think and feel and act in ways that aren't really us at all. And now we can move on to the crown chakra at the top of your head. Lord Ganesh and Archangel Michael, please cut any and all energetic attachments or cords to people, places, things, thoughts, feelings, emotions that are currently interfering with our ability to feel connected to all that is, all that ever has been, and all that ever will be. Allow us to feel as if we fit in to the universe, to the divine. Archangel Raphael, please heal any way in which we feel we do not align with or fit in with the universe, God, Source, Creator, whichever verbiage you want, and with the divine. I'm sensing so much love coming through for all of us right now as we heal and shift this particular chakra, as we heal and shift how we feel we are connected to the world, the earth, the universe, the divine, God, Source, Creator. And now we can move on to the crown chakra in the center of the forehead. Or I should say the third eye chakra in the center of the forehead. Lord Ganesh and Archangel Michael, please cut any and all cords and attachments associated with and interfering with our ability to clearly see the truth, the real truth, and to be able to clearly see how we fit into the universe, the world, and the divine, as well as our ability to clearly see our divine path in this lifetime, what our purpose is, and how we are meant to share our special gifts and abilities with the world. Archangel Raphael, please heal the third eye chakra in any and all ways necessary at this time. And now we can move on to the caudal chakra, right in the center of the back of the head. Lord Ganesh and Archangel Michael, please cut any and all cords and attachments associated with and interfering with our ability to clearly hear, process, translate, and understand any divine messages of guidance and support, any messages that we are meant to share with the world, and any messages and guidance that are for us alone. Please allow us to always clearly hear, understand, comprehend, and translate accurately all of these things. Archangel Raphael, please heal the caudal chakra in any ways needed and necessary at this time. And now we can move on to the throat chakra. Lord Ganesh and Archangel Michael, please cut any and all energetic attachments and cords interfering with and associated with our ability to clearly speak our truth, to stand in our power, to hear and to be heard. Allow us to never be afraid to speak up, to stand up for ourselves, and to show others who we truly are. As a soul being, as a spiritual being of love and light, not just simply human. Allow us the courage and wisdom to show people our unique abilities and gifts. And I'm sensing that this is, at this time, a particularly sticky issue. I'm sensing that a lot of people are not at all comfortable having people know what their gifts are and what they can actually do with their gifts and psychic abilities. And a lot of this stems from lifetimes in the past where we have been persecuted, perhaps even killed, because of people not understanding us, because of who we were, because of our abilities and our power. Psychic power, I mean. So a lot of us with this particular chakra and at this particular time, with everything that's going on in the world, might be having a really hard time standing in their power and speaking up and allowing others to see them and hear them for who they truly are, as well as learning to share and be of service with those same powers. Archangel Michael, Goddess Sophia, and Mary Magdalene, please heal the throat chakra in any and all ways needed and necessary at this time. And now we can move on to the heart and higher heart chakras. Lord Ganesh and Archangel Michael, please cut any and all cords and attachments associated with and interfering with our ability to love and be loved absolutely unconditionally. Allow us to feel safe and secure, giving and receiving love under any circumstances. Allow us to always recognize the difference between love and codependency issues or attachment issues or control issues from narcissistic people. Let us always clearly know and understand the difference between being treated with love and having somebody say that they love us and then misuse us, neglect us, or even abuse us. Let us heal and shift any way in which we are preventing ourselves from sending love to others, any way in which we have been feeling unstable, insecure, perhaps weak or low of energy, any way in which we've been feeling pain or hurt or sadness, or maybe even anger. And at this time, I would like to invite you to picture in your mind's eye any one person that happens to come to mind, which has been particularly frustrating for you. Somebody which you've been having a particularly tough time dealing with or being around lately. Whoever this person is, I'm sure it's the exactly, or I should say whoever this person is who pops into your mind, I'm sure it is the exact person that you need to be thinking about right now. And when this person pops into your mind, I would like to invite you to send them unconditional love. Send them love, send them light, send them positive thoughts. And allow yourself to feel whatever emotions come up for you as you do this. Whether it be just simply pain, whether it's sadness, whether it's fear, whether it's just this really uneasy feeling, whether it's an insecure feeling, allow whatever reaction you have physically to happen, whether it's tears or anything else that you might feel like doing at this time. Just allow yourself to do this. And just know that however it is that you're feeling towards this person, it's perfectly okay. You don't need to judge yourself on it. You don't need to criticize yourself on why you're feeling that way or why you've been behaving the way that you've been behaving towards them. From the highest possible spiritual perspective, there is no good or bad. It just all simply is. It's just a matter of accepting things as they are and processing it and digesting it how it is, rather than how we thought it should be or how we wanted it to be or how we expected it to be. And now, as you're sending this person love, this number one top frustrating person in your life, whether it be your twin flame, your partner, coworker, family member, whoever this person is, I want to invite you to really feel into not just your initial reaction to sending this person love and light. I mean, we all know it's not an easy thing to send love to somebody that we're having a really tough time with. Sometimes it brings up pain, hurt, anger, sadness, fear. But I want to invite you to feel into what else you're feeling besides that initial reaction. How does it really feel to be releasing the grudges, releasing that negative energy within that connection you have with that person, and filling yourself and the connection you have with that person with pure love and light? And now that is the emotion that you should be focusing more on. How it feels to be shifting and changing that connection to being a more positive, uplifting, and loving one. And now I would like you, or would like to invite you, to tuning into the collective, tuning into the universe, tuning into society, and really focusing on sending everything in existence love and light and healing. And tuning into how uplifting and powerful that feels within you. And now we can move on to the solar plexus chakra. Lord Ganesh and Archangel Michael, please cut any and all energetic attachments or cords associated with and interfering with our ability to truly step into our power, to feel safe, secure, and strong while doing so. Please allow us to always clearly see where our power is being stripped from, what people, places, things, thoughts, emotions, or feelings are disempowering to us, any ways in which we basically allowed ourselves to come out of alignment with our own power, any way in which we have allowed other things, people, or situations to have power over us. And now I would like to invite you to feel, sense, and maybe even see goddesses Isis and Ishtar standing immediately behind you, with both of their hands on each of your shoulders. And the affirmation that they are giving me to use right now, which I invite you to use as well, to say out loud or in your head, is, I am strong. I am courageous. I am tenacious. I am determined. I am brave. And I am wise. I can do all things. They are both sending you healing for this particular chakra and any and all ways needed at this time, helping you shift into your power to feel safe, stable, and secure, allowing you to clearly see, sense, and feel anything, person, place, thing, thought, emotion, feeling, or even situation that has been disempowering to you, allowing you to shift this back into you being in your power. Lord Ganesh is also playing a big part in this, being the obstacle breakthrough guru. I'm sensing that a lot of us have felt stuck in a certain situation that we knew was not beneficial or uplifting to us, but that we just didn't know how to remove ourselves from. And just know that this is being healed and shifted now. In the days, weeks, and months to come, you will be noticing a subtle but consistent shift where situations like this do end up changing, where you do end up seeing how it's affecting you, and you do end up stepping into your power and changing it. Even if at this current moment in time it feels like it's something that you have no control whatsoever of, just know that that is merely a perspective. It's not the real truth. It's not reality. You do actually have the utmost control over your life. You are not a victim. There is absolutely nothing that could possibly happen to you that you do not have control of. It's either happening for one of two reasons. One, because you allowed it to, or two, because you inadvertently ended up creating it intentionally or accidentally. You are the sole creator of your universe. You are the sole creator of your life. Everything you do, whether consciously or subconsciously, turns into your life. If things in your life are not how you would like them to be, it is up to you to show up for yourself better and figure out how you can manifest the things that you really do want without self-sabotaging yourself due to your subconscious doubts and fears and insecurities. And now we can move on to the sacral chakra. Lord Ganesh and Archangel Michael, please cut any and all cords and attachments associated with and interfering with our ability to feel powerful, to feel creative, to feel sexual, to enjoy sex, to enjoy being childlike and joyful. To enjoy being creative. Please allow us to always be able to tune into our inner child, our inner teenager aspects, to tune into our passion, our creativity, whether it be sexual passion or artistic passion. Allow us to always know what we are birthing into this life, and by birthing I mean creating, whether it be a business, a child, that you're birthing into this life, whether it's a business, whether it's art, whatever it is that would not have existed without you creating it, is what you are birthing into this world. That is your contribution to the collective. And that is an important and crucial thing to be focusing on right now, because this is the time in which we are meant to be delving deeper into how we can be of service, what it is that we are putting out into the world, how we are assisting, how we fit in, how our gifts and abilities can assist those, and how they fit in. And now we move on to the root chakra. Lord Ganesh and Archangel Michael, please cut any and all energetic attachments associated with and interfering with our ability to feel stable, strong, and grounded, and secure at all times, under any and all circumstances and conditions. Allow us to always feel connected and supported in all ways and at all times, both financially and energetically, with the divine, with our guides, with our spirit team. Let us always know that we are safe, that we are protected, that we are loved and nurtured always. Help us remove ourselves from any fear, insecurities, doubts that we might have associated with this. And now we move on to the feet chakras, located in the center of the arch on both of her feet. Lord Ganesh and Archangel Michael, please cut any and all energetic attachments and cords associated with and interfering with our ability to clearly see what lies ahead for us, to clearly see and receive our guidance for what we are meant to be doing on this earth at this time, in this life. Allow us to always have the wisdom and bravery to walk down this path. To accept those challenges with the help and assistance of Lord Ganesh, of course. No matter where our personal path seems to be leading, no matter what experiences we are currently having on our personal path, allow us to always feel safe and secure, loved and nurtured in all ways and at all times, no matter what we may currently be experiencing in our life on our path. Allow us to have the wisdom that no matter what we might be experiencing, no matter where we are in life, no matter what our life currently looks like, no matter how we may be currently feeling about how our life currently looks like, allow us to always know that we are exactly where we are supposed to be. Allow us to always know that we are exactly, that we are experiencing exactly what we are meant to be experiencing. We are experiencing exactly what we need to be experiencing for our highest soul growth and shifting and healing. Allow us to always know what it is that our current circumstances are there to help us learn, heal, and grow from. Archangel Raphael, please heal our feet chakras in any way needed and necessary at this time. And now we will move on to the Earth Star Chakra, which is about 1 foot below our physical feet. Lord Ganesh and Archangel Michael, please cut any and all energetic cords and attachments associated with and interfering with our ability to feel stable, grounded, calm, peaceful, and stable at all times under any circumstances. Archangel Raphael, please heal our Earth Star Chakra in any ways needed and necessary at this time. And now, whenever you are ready, you may open your eyes. Goddesses Ishtar and Isis are still standing right behind you, giving you their love and support and courage and wisdom. They wish to be your guides into these subconscious and darker aspects of yourself, to allow and assist you with deeper healing, with how you can be of service to the collective and to society, how you can share your gifts and how you fit in, and breaking through all of those boxes that others have put you in and that you have put yourself in regarding how you fit into society, which I sense is what this 4-4 portal is actually all about at this time. And with that, I bid you all adieu. I love you all and have a wonderful day or night wherever you are. And bye for now.